Hi everyone, I am Dr. Shilpi Badani. I'm a plastic surgeon at SB Aesthetics, Gurugram, India. So today we would be taking some frequently asked questions across various platforms on rhinoplasty. We've collected some frequently asked questions on these media, and these are often the most commonly asked questions in the consultations also. So the first question being, can I have rhinoplasty along with facelift surgery? Well, I would say no, because two major surgeries in one area of the body, usually a plastic surgeon will advise you against it. These should be two separate procedures. The healing time of both the procedures is about 7 to 8 days or 7 to 10 days. A rhinoplasty usually takes a few weeks to months to settle down. Facelift can take about a month to settle down. And ideally these two surgeries should be separate. The next question being, what is the minimum and maximum age for rhinoplasty? When we are considering rhinoplasty for cleft lip and palate, we can do rhinoplasty as early as puberty. Sometimes a small change to the nose is also made earlier around school going age. So given the indication, we can do rhinoplasty earlier, although a full blown rhinoplasty in cleft patient is also done at around puberty only, not before that. The usual age for any aesthetic rhinoplasty should be adulthood, that is after 18 years of age. The next question being whether one should at all go for a rhinoplasty when there are non-invasive options available. Well, you must understand that the non-invasive options do not qualify as a full rhinoplasty. They are not able to take care of a lot of problems that people come with. At the most, what a non-invasive procedure like a filler can do is give you a little sharper appearance. The hump can be camouflaged. The nose can be made to look a little leaner. But these also are not permanent, and usually these fillers wear off in about a year or year and a half, whereas a rhinoplasty is a full restructuring of the nose, and this is a permanent procedure. The question about, will I have a dressing or a plaster on the nose? Well, if any bone work is done, then yes, you will have a dressing or a plaster on the nose, mostly any time between 6 days to 10 days. Different surgeons prefer different times, but yes, you will have a dressing. If only cartilage work is done, then maybe you will have just a steri strip or a tape dressing rather than a full-blown plaster. So the question about, will my nose be blocked and will my smell sense of smell change? The nose in majority of the cases will be blocked in between 24 to 48 hours time, and during that time you have to breathe from your mouth. That time, of course, your sense of smell will not be there. Once the packs are removed, slowly things return to normal and you are able to smell as previous. So rhinoplasty really does not or should not change your sense of smell. The question about revision rhinoplasty, how long one has to wait before considering a revision in a rhinoplasty procedure? Well, in a rhinoplasty, usually changes settle down in about a year's time. However, if you're really unsatisfied and looking for an earlier change, then I would say nothing earlier than 6 months. You must wait for 6 months after your rhinoplasty, and ideally for 9 months to a year before considering a revision. Well, this question comes ever so often, whether you can get the nose shape as your favorite celebrity. The nose shape is a very individual character, and your nose has to suit your face. A nose which looks good on somebody else's face may not look good on you. So the aim of your rhinoplasty should be to give you a nose which is more suited to your face rather than somebody else's nose. So you must discuss this out with your surgeon, and expectations must be set before you undertake a rhinoplasty. So the question about touch-up or maintenance needed after a rhinoplasty procedure. Well, usually rhinoplasty is a permanent procedure. Most of the cases, one rhinoplasty is sufficient and no touch-up or maintenances are needed. However, you must keep in mind that it's a surgery and if required, revisions may be required, although in minor percentage of cases. Will insurance cover your rhinoplasty? Well, if your rhinoplasty is for aesthetic reasons, insurance usually does not cover. However, if you need a rhinoplasty as a fallout of deformed shape of nose due to trauma, or you have a septorhinoplasty, which is usually done to correct breathing problems, then your insurance may cover it. It differs between different insurance providers. You must check with your insurance for this. Before the surgery, can you really know how your nose is going to look like? Well, to a large extent, you can know, and there are a lot of simulation tools available to give you a picture of how your nose will look like after the rhinoplasty. However, you must understand that it's a very fine surgery and a lot of minor arrangements are done in the cartilage and bone to give you the shape of your that you desire in your nose. So simulation tools are good, but ultimately surgical work is something which is much finer than a simulation tool. How many stitches will I have? Will there be scars on my nose? Well, usually rhinoplasty scars are very concealed scars, and no one should be able to tell by scars that you've had a rhinoplasty. Usually these scars are under the nose and they heal very well over time, and these are not very discernible.